South Sudan and the situation there, where the government here is advising everyone who is working there, especially the traders that ply their business there, to give it a moment because of the ongoing insecurity. The caution was made by the State Minister for Foreign Affairs, Okello Oryem, during a news conference that was called today. Let's take a look.
There is a situation of insecurity in South Sudan on the road between Juba and Nimule, but that insecurity was recently addressed. When I went to South Sudan, we got assurances of increased patrol and increased vigilance in that region. That's why transport has resumed as normal to between Nimule and Juba.
The State Minister of Foreign Affairs, Okello Oryem, agreed to the fact that business is booming in South Sudan and there is a lot of money for the risk takers. However, he warned that those who can't risk shouldn't go there because there is a lot of insecurity. He disclosed that as East African countries, they have held several talks about the insecurity in South Sudan and finally agreed with South Sudan leadership to deploy enough security from Elegu border to the capital city of South Sudan, Juba, so that traders and truck drivers operating there are given protection.
If you hope that you will go and do business in South Sudan in this kind of climate without the challenges of South Sudan, then you should not be going to do business in South Sudan. South Sudan has its challenges, just like every country has its challenges. At the moment they're trying to re-establish its army, there's a time they're trying to restore peace and security. They went through a very rough time in 2013 and 2017, but these are now being overcome. But in between, you have some rebel groups which are making it difficult for the government of the day.
Relatedly, government has warned that UPDF will be forced to go after the ADF, who have continued to cause insecurity at the Ugandan borders. This is after insecurity spread from Democratic Republic of Congo to the Ugandan border nearing Congo.
The situation in DRC is wanting. We totally condemn the activities of the ADF causing insecurity in our borders. We want to put them on notice that if they continue in the manner in which they continue, the UPDF will hesitate to pursue them in hot pursuit and eliminate them once and for all. We are sick and tired of the ADF continuously causing insecurity on our borders with the DRC.
The minister also encouraged investors to come and trade in Uganda, citing the favorable business and insecurity environment, which will enable them reap enough profits.
Set up commercial farms in Uganda, pay taxes in Uganda, employ Ugandans, and let us make money as a country and develop our country. That's what I want. Anybody who comes to Uganda should pay taxes, employ Ugandans, and take the opportunity in Uganda. If you come to Amuru, I wish you come to Amuru. You ever been to Amuru? And you see those miles and miles of land by foreign farmers. Are they paying taxes? They're paying taxes. Are they playing Ugandans? They're playing Ugandans. This is what we want.
Story by Jariat Namuwaya for the news.